to work with this American company, Enico. Were you asked to design or redesign this chair that was originally designed in the 1930s, 1940s? What was it like when you did approach a project like that?
There is many reasons. The first reason, the owner of Emeco, called Greg Buschbinger, Bab, how you said? She sleep also. Greg Buchbinder is an absolute angel. This guy is come from the sky, from the paradise, and is the prototype of the next boss, manager of company. He is honest, correct, he have ethic, a moral, a vision, he's a real guy. And when I can help and work with somebody like that, I always do it. The second reason is, since years, I have produced some chairs the cheapest possible. And the cheapest possible means plastic, mold plastic. When you inject plastic to make a good, affordable product, there is no human to do it. That means it's purely machine which make shrunk-tunk, shrunk-tunk. That means when you give profit for the final user, there is no profit for the person, for the worker. More you multiplicate the, I'm sorry for my French, the profit for people, less there is people who live with the work. It's okay. But with Emeco, I have the opportunity to rebalance that. Emeco, it's exactly the contrary. They don't make a lot of chairs, because it's all made by hand, with a real know-how of people. Some work in this company since 42 years. And and there is not a lot of people who can have, there is not a lot of users who can have the profit of this chair. But for the people who do it, it's a real good thing. That's why I call it heritage, because I inherit. Greg gave me this company and said, make something with that. And I just respect the product. I just try to keep the essence and do it a little more practical, because before it was not stackable. And a chair today which is not folding, I don't know, or stackable, it's not modern, because people have no rooms to do that. That's why I just do that. I just make some, I wash it a little, and I make it a little more convenient. But more, I said, if everybody continue to make only plastic chair, these people will die, and we shall forget this know-how. And this know-how is more than a professional know-how, is a life, is sweat, it's blood, and it's beauty. That's why it's good to protect everything. I protect people who have no money to buy this, which is expensive, and who are very happy to have a $5 chairs, like next year at Target. But I protect the people also who know make something like that. I'm sorry, it's not easy with my very bad French.